Well, hello YouTubers, how are you guys doing? Today we're going to be taking a test drive in this 1999 GMC Yukon SLT as a follow-up from posting the test drive of that 2015 GMC Yukon SLT. And I've been wanting to do a test drive of this truck for years. This is finally my opportunity. And just before we get started, let's go ahead and do a little overview and update on of what's happened since the in-depth review. The intake has been updated. It's got the original 5.7 liter 350 cubic inch L31 Vortec V8, and as you can see, it has its new factory air box. If you saw my in-depth review, it had a K&N cold air intake that has been removed in replacement for this. I like this. I prefer this better since it's in a box and it doesn't suck in hot air from anywhere inside the engine compartment. Also, it does have a brand new alternator put on. That sums up under the hood. Now, without further ado, let's go ahead and take this thing on a test drive. Alright. Yeah, the fuel gauge is messed up. Let's go ahead and start the engine. Fires up instantly. So now let's go ahead and get to the drive. Alright, can't wait for those to finish walking by. It's actually a pretty loaded model for a 99. It has the auto dimming rearview mirror with compass and outside temperature, leather seats. They are a bit worn out because it's gotten a lot of use out of it over the years. So anyway, let's go and get to the drive. And by the way, I found out what exhaust system this truck has on it. It's actually a Flowmaster Super 40s. I mean, in the in-depth review you saw, I didn't know whether it was either a Flowmaster or Magnaflow, but I've confirmed it. It's a Flowmaster. Thing that might need to be addressed one day. The ABS light is on. Let's try and get the AC going because it's kind of hot this morning or this afternoon. Overall, this truck rides pretty smooth, being that this thing is almost 20 years old, or actually it's almost, I miscounted, it's actually almost 18 years old. Exhaust system sounds very good. Been on the truck for years, ever since I was 3 years old. I gotta say, the AC works very good. It practically froze me out. That's why I had to turn it down just a little. that was just a quarter push on the pedal, and it's already up to 25 miles an hour. Take you out on the open road a little. I'm not gonna do a highway run to this truck. This is as close to an open road test drive as y'all are gonna get. And then again, I've changed my mind. We'll go the other way. Although I said I'm not going to go on the highway, I'm just going to stay on the access road. So, this is as close to a highway run as you'll ever get in this video. Sounds very good at wide open throttle. Just a bit of cosmetics wrong with it, as if you can see this little visor's hanging down, but you don't have to give up drivability for that. And it's a fairly comfortable riding truck as well. Got a leather-wrapped steering wheel. I've always loved the style of these older Chevy GMC steering wheels. And I've always loved this body style as well, since I grew up around them. My mother had a 99 Suburban. My dad actually had a 92 K3500 with a big block 454. Oh, and also my mom had a 95 Chevy Tahoe. Same color as this truck, except hers was, like I said, being a 95, it had the old 350 TBI motor, so very old school. But this 350 Vortex does have some get up and go. Drivability of this thing is amazing. I suspected that it would have a much more rougher ride, but it's exceptionally smooth. But I think that's the thing with Chevy and GMCs. They have such smooth suspension. This one has this suspension, and this is all stock. The wheels are all stock, despite the fact they're missing the hubcaps. You can see on the dash the oil pressure gauge is low, but that's just normal because, well, it stays low until the engine's revved up, as you can see. It does have a little bit of a chassis wobble, but bet some people that drove these older vehicles are probably used to that. I sure am. Well, my 06 Silverado doesn't have that much of a chassis quiver. Like I said, this truck is the SLT model, so it's basically like Chevrolet's LT package. Well, it's basically just like it since it has the leather interior and a lot of creature comforts, like the overhead compass and outside temperature. That shows the outside temperature now. This button should show your compass. Now back to outside temperature. Love the sound of that exhaust. I always thought Flowmaster has a very nice sound on their exhaust systems. They are a bit loud, but not too droney. That's what I love about the Super 40s. Down here. also, if you've seen my in-depth review, you've seen this truck is four-wheel drive. It's a nice feature to have. You probably already tell, because in the gauge cluster, as an indicator that says service four-wheel drive, it's also another dead giveaway that this thing is four-wheel drive. But anyway, our test drive video of this 1999 GMC Yukon SLT has pretty much come to an end. I'm just about to make a stop right here by the elementary school to drop off some trash, so hope you guys enjoyed the video. Please like, rate, comment, and subscribe. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.